Hi, this is Julián from MinuteEarth. When a grizzly bear catches a salmon, she'll first peel off and gobble up the skin, then numb the brain. But then she's likely to abandon the rest of the fish, several kilograms worth, and go back to the river to catch another. On average, bears abandon about half of their yearly haul. But why? I mean, catching fish can be a real bear. It doesn't seem to make sense to waste all that time and effort. But the bear is acting much more logically than you might think, because the process of acquiring food isn't just about getting it into your paws, it's also about getting it from your paws to your jaws, and eventually your belly. And sure, that's easy for some animals and some foods, but for others, the processing is just as hard or harder than getting a paw on it in the first place, or a beak or fang. For a bear in salmon season, fish is easy to come by. Dismantling that fish is what takes the real time and energy. Some parts of a salmon are more worthwhile than others. The fattiest bits of the fish, the skin, the brain, and the eggs, are the most calorie-rich and easiest to access. The rest of the fish's flesh, which is much leaner and not nearly as rewarding, is tucked amidst dangerously sharp broken bones, which are really hard to pick apart. And for a bear, time is money, or really salmon-y. Time spent processing food is time not spent catching more food, baby making, or keeping an eye out for foes. The same is true for critters like spotted hyenas, gray wolves, orcas, midges, spiders, and foxes, whose prey also takes time to dismantle. When there's plenty of prey to be had, these animals will often kill more prey than they can eat, consuming the best bits and leaving the rest barely touched. Meanwhile, a pelican, which spends far more time searching for fish than eating them, will eat pretty much everything it can catch. Generally, the more time a critter has to spend eating its prey, the more often it should abandon what it has already caught and try for something better. Of course, animals don't actually do complex math to figure out what's worthwhile. These decisions are generally driven by instincts honed over millions of years of natural selection, supplemented by their past experiences and info they've gained from others. And even when a bear decides that a salmon in the paw isn't worth two in the stream, that fish doesn't actually go to waste. The discarded meat gets picked over by other animals, and whatever's left over is decomposed by even smaller critters, creating a nutrient-rich landscape that can bear even more bears.